Hi friends, I am so excited to see you today. It is time to worship God, to sing and dance and let Him know how much we love Him. Because God loves you and God loves me. He always has and He always will. So stand up on your feet and let's sing this together. Hello friends, I'm Miss Brittany and I love learning about new things. I have always wanted to know how to draw better. So a friend let me borrow her book and it's gonna help me do just that. Look at all the fun things that I get to learn how to draw now. Books are so helpful. But what if I want to learn about God? Is there a book that I can read to hear from God? You're right, it's our Bible. The Bible is God's word to us. And today, our true story comes from the Old Testament. This true story from the Bible is about a king. Nope, that's not the king. The king was younger. Nope, that's not him either. Getting closer. This king was much younger. There he is. See how young he is? His name was King Josiah. He was a very young king. Can you help me find out how old he was? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, King Josiah was 8. Most 8-year-old kids are making artwork. Most 8-year-old kids are building blocks. Most 8-year-old kids are playing at the park. King Josiah wasn't making artwork and he wasn't building blocks or playing at the park. 8-year-old Josiah was king. King Josiah loved God and he wanted to hear from God. I know I want to hear from God. Raise your hand high in the air if you want to hear too. Yeah, well, one day, some of King Josiah's workers found something very special. They found a scroll. Scrolls are like books, and the scroll King Josiah workers found had God's words on it. King Josiah was so excited that all he wanted to do was read and read and read what God had written. King Josiah began reading God's words as much as he could, so he could hear from God. And because of everything King Josiah read, he wanted to do what God said. Josiah loved God, and he knew God loved him. God loves someone else too. God loves you, and God loves me. That's right. God loves us so much, and that's why he gave us a book where we can hear from him. Friends, do you know what book I'm talking about? Yes, you're right, it's our Bible. The Bible is full of stories and words from God about who God is, how he would live, and how much God loves us. The Bible is like a "I love you" from God. Give yourself a great big hug to show you how much God loves you. Our big idea today is God loves me. So when I ask, who loves you? God loves me. Yes, God loves me. Should we pray together? Go ahead, fold your hands and close your eyes and pray with me. Dear God, thank you for sharing your words with us in the Bible. Help us learn more about you and hear from you through these stories. Thank you for always loving us, God. We love you too. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, I have some questions for you today about our Bible story. First, how old was King Josiah? Do you remember? We counted. 8. And what did King Josiah's workers find? A scroll with all of God's words on it. Yes. Most important, who loves you? Tell me. God loves me. Yes, he does. All right, let's go over our memory verse. This month, our memory verse comes from Jeremiah 31:3, which is in the Old Testament before Jesus was born. Go ahead, stand up with me and let's do the motions. I will always love you. Jeremiah 31:3. Let's try that one more time. Ready? I will always love you. Jeremiah 31:3. Okay, have you been thinking about kids camp? I have, and it's going to be so much fun. This week, I want you to find your Bible and put it somewhere special, like we did our prayer pals. Do you remember? Mine's still on my bed. Do you think I should bring mine to class next week? I'm gonna. Oh wait, next weekend is also Mom's Day, Mother's Day. We need to make sure we do something special for whoever makes you feel special, like your mom or your nana or your aunt or your grandma. Should we do that? I'll see you then. Bye.